Children, this is your computer period. In previous class, we study about the secondary memory in chapter 3, computer memory. In the very first lecture, we study that what is memory, what is the types of memory, primary, secondary. In primary memory, there are also two kinds of memory, permanent, temporary. And what are these? ROM and RAM. ROM is permanent memory and RAM is temporary. I have shared the question answers of this chapter with you. And there was a difference given in answer 4. So that you can easily differentiate between RAM and ROM. You will read this. I have uploaded lectures on that also. If you want, then you can watch them again. After that, we differentiate between bit, byte, and nibble. What are these? These are the units of measurement of. After that, we study about secondary memory. Secondary memory is external, whereas primary memory is internal, or we can call it main memory. And second is external, because it is not inside our CPU. Okay, we can connect secondary memory with the help of USB ports and slots, like we have inserted our hard disk externally also. It is internal as well as external, like our USB flash drives, compact disk. There is a CD drive given on the CPU where we can insert our CD, DVD and Blu-ray discs. We study about hard disk, which is a made up of a metallic box and it is coated with magnetic material from inside. Okay. This is our hard disk. How is it look like? After that, we differentiate between the three types of compact disks. That is compact disk read-only memory, recordable and rewritable. And we differentiate CD, DVD and Blu-ray disk. They are different to each other in terms of the capacity. Here it is mentioned that CD can hold data up to 700 MB. DVD can hold up to data between 4.2 GB to 8.4 GB, whereas Blu-ray disc has the maximum among all the three. It has 25 GB to 50 GB. Now let's move to our another topic, which is floppy disk. What is floppy disk? Floppy disk is also a secondary storage device. Floppy disk is used for storing and backing up a small amount of data, as it is clear from its first line that it can only store small amount of data. It is circular thin plastic disc coated with magnetic material. On which material is coated on that? Magnetic material. And with which is it made up of? It is made up of plastic, and magnetic material is coated on it. Okay, a hard plastic outer cover protects this plastic disc. The disc is of plastic, which is inside this box, and that is coated with magnetic material. And whatever you are seeing in this picture, this is the outer cover which protect that plastic disc with magnetic. And this device is known as floppy disk. The storage capacity of floppy disk is usually up to 1.44 MB. It is not in common use nowadays, because it was used before, because it can hold very less memory. It can hold less than a CD, just like our CD has 700 MB. Very low capacity. It can hold only up to 1.44 MB only. Okay. कैपेसिटी. नाउ अ डेज वी डू नॉट यूज़ फ्लॉपी, इट इज़ नॉट ऑफ यूज नाउ अ डेज. नाउ नेक्स्ट मूव टू यूएसबी फ्लैश ड्राइव. वी ऑल हैव पेन ड्राइव्स एट अवर होम्स. वी यूज टू वॉच मूवीज, वी यूज टू वॉच वीडियोज लाइक वेडिंग वीडियोज और पार्टी वीडियोज और एनी काइंड ऑफ वीडियोज. वी हैव A USB flash drive or a pen drive is a portable storage. Portable means we take this with us to anywhere. We can keep this in our pocket. Used to easily transfer audio, video and it means to say sharing of data, any kind of data like audio, video, data files. We can share or transfer it from one system to another. In order to use a flash drive, a computer must have a USB port. In CPU, there is a USB port. In laptops also, USB port is given on the left and right side of the laptop where keyboard is placed. So, these are the slots or we can call them USB ports where we can insert our pen drives. The storage capacity of USB flash drive is from 128 MB to up to 64 GB. So till now we have seen that our USB flash drive is smaller in size, but it can have a good capacity. The storage capacity of USB flash drive is better than all the disks given here. Okay, it is portable, it is smaller in size and it can hold a large amount of data. Given here 128 MB to up to 64 GB, that much. Now let's move to memory card. What is that memory card? See, I have already showed you this in presentation, what is memory card. So sometimes what happened, our phone does not have that much space so that we can save important data into it. So what we do, we purchase a memory card from the shop, we purchase a memory card and then we insert it into our mobile phone so that it will be easy to download the documents, the audio files, the video files, and it will automatically save to the memory card. So it is also a storage device. A memory card is a small storage medium used to store data such as text, pictures, audio and video for use on small portable devices like digital camera and mobile phones. It has a capacity of 64 MB up to 16 GB. See, memory cards not only use in phones, but we can use them into our digital camera. But those memory cards are very different from those which use in phones. So how do we transfer data from digital cameras to our system? With the help of these cards, we insert that card into card reader or we will insert a USB port so that we can transfer the data from our digital camera to the system. Last one is solid state disk. What is that solid state disk? A SSD is just like a memory card. Solid state disk. Memory card is very light. It is we have seen that it is a chip like thing, very easy to portable and very smaller in size. And just like memory card, a solid state disk is there which has more storage capacity than all the devices we have read till now. So a solid state disk is just like a memory card that has a capacity from 2 GB up to 256 GB, that much. It is a flash disk that is more efficient and robust than hard disk. इट इज़ ए फ्लैश डिस्क दैट इज मोर एफिशिएंट एंड रोबस्ट देन हार्ड डिस्क. इट इज़ कॉमनली यूज इन लैपटॉप्स एंड नेटबुक्स फॉर और एज अ स्टोरेज डिवाइस. नाउ ऑल द ऑक्सिलरी स्टोरेज डिवाइसेज, ऑक्सिलरी दैट इज अवर सेकेंडरी स्टोरेज डिवाइस और एक्सटर्नल स्टोरेज डिवाइसेज आर बोथ इनपुट एज वेल एज आउटपुट. दे एक्ट एज इनपुट डिवाइसेज वैन यू स्टोर द डेटा एंड दे बिकम आउटपुट डिवाइस वैन यू रिट्रीव द डेटा. सो अवर ऑल द मेमोरी डिवाइसेज और स्टोरेज डिवाइसेज वर्क एज इनपुट एज वेल एज आउटपुट डिवाइस. मीन्स वी कैन स्टोर डेटा एंड वी कैन रिट्रीव इट वैन एवर वी वॉन्ट. ओके. A computer system is organized with a balanced configuration of different types of memories. The primary memory, that is RAM, is used to store the program currently executed by the computer. The primary memory is used to store the program currently executed. I told you, whenever you are working on a file, the data will save until the work will finish. After that, it will be vanish just because of RAM, random access memory. It is a read write memory, but if the computer will shut down, the data will erase automatically. So you have to save the data if you do not want that it will be vanished. When you work on computer, you work with RAM. Disks are used to store large data files and program files. These are useful in case of a disk failure. Why do we use disk for storing large data files and program files? These are used in case of a disk failure. CD, DVD, Blu-ray disc and USB flash drive are used to store large text, audio, video, data which can be carried anywhere. Means our USB flash drive, our memory card, are so portable that we can store text inside it or audio inside it or video inside it, and we can carry them anywhere. So your chapter ends here. This is your chapter 3, computer memory. Revise that chapter because I will give that chapter in PA1 exams also. So watch each and every video carefully. If you want any kind of help with me, I will help you. You can make call to me. If there is any doubt in any topic, you can take my help. But read the chapter carefully and just do the question answers. I have already shared, I think last week I have shared this PDF to you. So complete your copies as soon as possible and start revision, so you will score good marks in your exams. Okay, till then take care and be safe. Bye.